Sequence is a collection which contains several items or operations performed one after another. So in Python, we have several types of sequences such as lists, tuples, strings, etc. So in the previous video, we have talked about lists and strings. So in this video, we'll be focusing on tuples. So before that, a tuple is a data structure. So what do you mean by data structure? Data structure are the structures that hold and organize data or information. So previously we have talked about a list, which is also a data structure. So in this video, we are going to concentrate on tuples. So now what do you mean by tuples? A tuple is an immutable sequence of Python objects, whereas list is a mutable one, and tuples or sequences just like list. The difference between tuples and list are that tuples cannot be changed, that is, tuples are immutable unlike lists, and tuples use parentheses whereas lists use square brackets. This is the basic difference between tuples and list. So sequences such as lists, tuples and strings share the following common features. So our first feature is that each sequence contains a finite number of elements, and the elements are arranged in some order. That is, we can access these elements with the help of index value. So that is common for all these sequences, and it is possible to iterate over the elements. That is, we can use looping statements to iterate over the elements, and it is also possible to check whether an element in a sequence is present or not. So tuple is another data type that is similar to list. So it's a sequence data type. So here, this is how we will create tuples. Here, in this number is nothing but it is the name of that particular tuple, whereas each element of the tuples are separated by comma, and the elements are enclosed in parentheses. So these values that make up a tuple are called as elements. So elements in a tuple need not be of same type, they can be heterogeneous. That is, here we are having string, integer values, floating point values, as well as single character. So the elements in a tuple are addressed using their index values. So the main difference between lists and tuples are, lists are enclosed within square brackets, but whereas in tuples, the elements are enclosed within parentheses, and the tuples are immutable, that is, the values cannot be changed. So we cannot perform insert, update and delete operations on them. So that's why tuples are faster and more efficient than lists. We can also create an empty tuple, and also we can create a tuple with single element. So this is a tuple which has single element in it. So if a tuple comprises a single element, the element should be followed by a comma to distinguish a tuple from a parenthesized expression. So a tuple having a single element is also known as singleton tuple. So while creating a tuple with single element, comma after single value is mandatory. Otherwise, it is not considered as tuple, rather treated as a character or a string or even an integer. So let me show this with an example. Now I'm creating tuple t1 with element 1. So I'm giving comma. So another tuple, here I'm not giving comma. So now if I try to print type of t1, and also I'm printing the type of t2. So now if I run this code, yeah, type of t1 is tuple because we gave comma over here, and type of t2 is integer because we omitted comma. Now we can also create tuple with the help of predefined function called tuple. So let t3 equal to tuple, which means this statement is creating a tuple named t3, which is an empty tuple. Or else we can create an empty tuple in another way, like I'm just simply giving this parenthesis. So these two statements are same. Here, the only difference is that here we are using this predefined function, but here we are just giving parentheses. Now look at this example. Here I am creating a T3 tuple and I am also creating T4 tuple using predefined function called tuple. So now if I try to print T3 and T4, I am getting the same output because these two statements are same. The only difference is that in the first statement I am directly creating a tuple, and in the second statement I am just using a predefined function tuple to create a tuple named T4. So we can also create tuples by getting elements from the user. So now look at this example. Here in the statement 1 I am getting input from the user and storing it in n. So in statement 2 I am creating a single value tuple where this n is getting passed, and now if I try to print t, then a single value tuple is getting printed. So and then if I try to remove this comma, then let us see what happens. Yeah, it's showing an error that int object is not iterable. So we are getting this error because this comma after single value is mandatory, otherwise it is not considered as tuple, rather treated as a character or a string or an integer. So that is why this comma after this single value is very important. So tuples can also be nested, that is tuples can be placed inside other tuples. So when you add one or more tuples inside another tuple, the items in the nested tuples are combined together to form a new tuple. So here we have two tuples inside this bigger one. So these two tuples got added and it's returning as a single tuple named T1. So this is all about tuples creation. Now we will talk about accessing and traversing a tuple. So a tuple is a sequence of values which can be of any type and they are indexed by an integer. So if you want to access the elements of a tuple, you will be using that index value to access the elements, and like list, it can be, the index value can be either positive or negative. So now let me show this with an example. Now I am creating T1 with elements 1, 2, 3, 4. Now if I want to access the second element, then I will be print T1 of 1. So 1 is the index position of the second element. Yeah, now 2 is getting printed. So the starting value of the index is always 0. So the tuple index has to be positive or negative, or an expression which evaluates to an integer. So positive value of index means counting forward from the beginning of the tuple, and negative value means counting backward from the end of the tuple. So now if I try to print T1 of minus 1, yeah, 4 is getting printed because it is counting from the end. So this index value can also be an expression. So for example, print T1 of 5 minus 4, which is nothing but 1. So the element at that position will be printed. Yeah, 2 is getting printed because 5 minus 4 is 1. So 1 is the index value of 2. So like list, the elements of the tuples can also be accessed. So now I am creating a tuple named TUP with this following elements. So for I in tup, which means in the first iteration the first element of the tuple will be printed, and in the second iteration the second element will be printed and it goes on like that. So now look at this example. Now I am creating a tuple. So a equal to len of tup, which means I'm using this predefined function called len, which will return the number of elements in that particular tuple. So here the a value is 4 because 4 elements are there in this tuple. So for I in range a, which means range 4. So 0 to 4 minus 1 is I iterates from 0 to 3. So when if I try to print top of 0, then the element at that 0th index will be printed first, and in the second and in the next iteration I value will be 1. So the element at that first index value index will the index value 1 will be printed, and it goes on like that. Now we will talk about some common tuple operations. Our first operation is slicing. So this slicing is common among all the sequence data types, that is list, strings and tuples. So here this is an example for slicing operation. This 1 is nothing but start point and 5 is nothing but end point. So now I am going to slice from start to end minus 1, that is 1 to 4. So all the elements in that particular index will be printed. So negative index is also possible. So now I am giving minus 7 to minus 2 or minus 6 to minus 2. Yeah, all the elements in that particular index is getting printed. So here minus 8 is in the index minus 1, so 7 is in the index minus 2, and 6 is in the index minus 3, so it goes on like that. So now we will talk about concatenation of tuples. So here I am creating a tuple named T3 and a tuple named T4. So now if I try to concatenate these two tuples with the help of plus sign, so I am just getting a new tuple with all the elements. The elements got concatenated. So now look at this example. So we can also use plus operator with tuple slice. So now if I try to concatenate T1 plus 2, print. Now if I try to print this, I will get an error because tuples can be added only with another tuple, not with an integer string or any other data type values. So if you want to concatenate this particular element, then you can print T1 comma 2 comma. So now you will not get any error. It's directly getting added. So now tuple multiplication. So this multiplication operator is used for repetition of the tuple. So T1 equal to 1 comma 2 comma 3 comma 4 comma 5. So now print T1 into 2. Yeah, all the elements is getting printed twice. So if suppose this can also be done, this can also be used with slicing. Here I'm going to slice this tuple 1, 2, 3. Yeah. Here only that particular sliced element is getting printed twice. So now we will talk about membership operator, that is in and not in. So 1 in T1, print 1 in T1. Yeah, it's returning true because 1 is present in that tuple. Now let me use not in operator. 1 not in T1, this will return false because 1 is present in T1. And we can also compare two tuples using comparison operators 1, 2, 3 less than 4, 5, 6. Now look at this example. Here I want to compare tuple 1 with tuple 2. I want to check whether tuple 2 is greater than tuple 1. So here the first element of tuple 1 is compared with the first element of tuple 2. So if it is equal, then the second element will be compared, and it goes on like that. Now in this example, 1 is obviously less than 4. So this particular expression will return true. So now we will talk about some important tuple functions. So now I am creating tuple 1, 2, 3, 4. So now if I want to find the length of this particular tuple, I can use the len function. Len of t1. Print, I am directly printing this length. Yeah, it's returning 4. So this function returns the length of a tuple, that is count the total number of elements in a tuple. And we have one more inbuilt function called count. So this function is used to count the occurrence of an element in the tuple. So now I am giving t1 print t1 dot count. So now I am going to count 2. Yeah, it's returning 1 because the number of occurrences of 2 is 1, only 1. And we have one more function called any. This function returns 2 if the tuple is having at least 1 item. If the tuple is empty, it will return false. Now if I try to print any of A, print any of print any of t1, so here it's returning true because we have elements in that particular tuple. So now let us take another example, t2. This is an empty tuple. So now if I try to print any t2, it will return false because it is an empty tuple. So now we are going to talk about another important function called as min and max function. So this max function shall return the element with maximum value from the tuple, and on the other end, min function shall return the element with minimum value from the tuple. So this print min t1 will return 1 and print max t1 will return 4. So now look at this example. Now I am creating a tuple named tup. So if I print max of tup, yeah, here it's generating an error because this tup holds values of different data types. So max and min function generates an error as these functions work only with elements of same data type. So this point is to be noted. So just keep this in mind. Both the functions work well with tuples containing string values as well. So if tup equal to python, now if I try to print max of tup, yeah, y is getting printed. So this is the because the ASCII value of y is larger than other elements, we can also print min of tup. Yeah, now h is getting printed. So our next topic is deleting a tuple. So this can be done with the help of a keyword called del. So now look at this example. If I try to delete this tuple t1, then after deleting, if I try to print t1, I'm getting error because this t1 got deleted already. Now, so that's why we are getting an error like this. T1 is not defined, which means the deleted element will not be printed again. So here comes the important point to be noted, that you can't add elements to a tuple because of their immutable property. So there is no append or extend method for tuples, and you can't even remove elements from a tuple. This is also because of its immutable property. So tuples have no remove or pop function. You can just delete the entire tuple by using keyword, but you can't delete individual elements of a tuple. So now let us finish this session by discussing some of its advantages and disadvantages. So for first advantage is that tuples use less memory, whereas list use more memory. So we can use tuples in a dictionary as a key, but it's not possible with list. So we can access elements with an index in both tuples and list. So the disadvantages of using tuples is that we can't add an element to a tuple because of its immutable property, and we can't sort a tuple. But in list we can sort by calling sort method. So and we can't even remove an element in a tuple, but in list we can remove an element. So we can't replace an element in a tuple, but we can replace it in a list. So these are the basic advantages and disadvantages of tuple. So in our next video we'll be discussing about dictionaries.